All right, guys. So this quick topic, because we are running out of time. We have just 3 minutes. So this table compression, guys, I'll quickly walk you through. This is one topic least used. So this table compression is a method that was introduced in 9i. What you do is, when you create a table, you specify the compress option over there. So what happens is, whenever you insert the records inside the table, they will be compressed, and that way you are saving disk space. Now, I'm jumping right onto the conclusion. When to use it and when to not to use it. Use it when space is important to you. And don't use it if CPU load is important to you, because this activity, or every time you perform an insert, it is CPU intensive activity and it puts a load on your server CPU. So what happens is, because every insert needs to be compressed and put into the data block, the problem is there is an overhead on CPU. So use this option. Again, there are some recommendation. If you see these considerations, you need to consider a few stuff before you use this compress option. So I directly jumped onto the conclusion, but how do you create a table with compress option? Is you just write compress, because by default, when you create any table space, it comes with no compress option. Like, we don't have to specify, but that's the default option. I think I mentioned it. You must add compress clause while creating table. By default, every table is created with no compress option. So you can use this query to check whether the table is compressed or not. And if you want to change the status of an already created table into compress, like, you can use these commands. And remember, if you are changing from no compress to compress, then old records will not be compressed. Only the new records will be compressed. But in case if you also want to compress the old records, then these are the commands. You move the table, no compress, and then you move back the table to compress method. So that way, remember, guys, don't run these commands in real time. I think I should have a note over here, because one junior DBA ran this command and we went into a trouble. Because what happens is, when you move to no compress, let's take you compress the table. Now you're moving to no compress. Oracle will create a duplicate table inside the database. Now you need to have that much space. All right, so if you don't have space, that will be a trouble. So be careful. I think there should be a note over here. And I also have included how to compress partitions. You can compress, and all the partitions that you create in a table, that will also be compressed. Also, you can have different partition. One partition is compressed, another one is not compressed. And check the partition compression levels with this query. So I want you all to go through this one. Now we are almost left with 1 minute, guys. So these considerations you need to follow before you use this compression method. So guys, because we are running out of the time, any doubts, please send me an email.